There is a beautiful shloka in the first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. It says, Na uttama shloka vartanam jushatam tat kathamritam syat sambhramontakalepi swaratam tat padam bhujam. Na uttama shloka vartanam jushatam tat kathamritam. The person who takes pleasure in the nectarian narrations of the Supreme Lord Krishna throughout his life need not run into any misconceptions or confusions or bewilderments at the time of leaving one's material body. So at the time of death, one's consciousness is focused on those activities or thoughts or experiences that the person has throughout one's life. If we lead our life in a devotional way, in a spiritual way, keeping Krishna consciousness and Bhakti Yoga as the center of our life, then even at the time of death also, we will be able to have spiritual thoughts. And with those spiritual thoughts and remembrance of the Supreme Lord, one can easily attain the lotus feet of Krishna in the spiritual world. So that's why this shloka says, Jushatam tat kathamritam syat sambhramo antakalepi smaratam tat padam bhujam. Even at the time of death also, one will have a clear understanding of spiritual consciousness and one will be able to attain the supreme destination without having to meditate on all the unfulfilled material desires in this life. That's why Krishna also says in Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Antakale cha mameva smaran muktva kalevaram yah prayati samadbhavam yati nastyatra samshayah. Means, at the time of death, one who remembers Krishna can easily attain Krishna. And there is no doubt in it. And Krishna himself personally promises it. And Krishna does not give a false promise. So, we need to live a life centered in Krishna consciousness so that at the end of life, one can be sure of a spiritual destination, whatever Krishna sanctions for us. Hare Krishna.